deep in the battle of GPUs, AMD seems to have taken a little snooze. Okay, I'm exaggerating, but seriously, AMD's GPU game lately, a tad on the slow side, especially when you put them side by side with Nvidia's rapid releases. Breaking news, AMD has finally graced us with the 77 and 7800 XT. It took them a hot minute, didn't it? Maybe AMD's just been super nostalgic. After all, they've clung onto that 6000 series like I cling to my childhood teddy bear. And just between us, I think they've been using it as a sneaky little cover-up. Like, hey, we don't need to release new cars. We've got these oldies but goodies right here. Nice try, AMD. We see what you did there. Looking at the specs, the RX 7600 emerges as this generation's answer to the 6650 XT. Identical in core, TMU, and ROC counts, it also mirrors the memory box of its predecessor. But here's the interesting twist. The 7600's base clocks took a dip by 16%, yet it manages a slight uptick in boost clocks, albeit by 1%. Comparatively, its cores lag behind the 3060 and the slimmed down 4060. However, the RX 7600 pulls ahead with superior TMU and ROC counts. While it ties with the 4060 on memory bus, the 3060 flexes a bit, showcasing a broader memory bus and greater memory size. This could hint at a performance edge, but let's reverse judgment for now. As for memory specs, the RX 7600 remains consistent in clock speeds and even manages to surpass Nvidia counterparts. Price-wise, the RX 7600 rings up at $258. It's a tad pricier than its forerunner, the 6650 XT, at $245. Meanwhile, the 3060 enjoys a modest saving of about $20, while the 4060 tags an extra $40. This places the 7600 in an intriguing spot concerning its value, something we'll delve into further. A significant point to highlight is the RX 7600's monolithic die structure. Unlike the broader RDNA 3 lineup with multiple dies for memory and compute, the 7600 consolidates everything into a single 6nm die, a choice that, to some, may not be the step forward they were hoping for. Let's dive into the world of 1080p rasterization. Right off the bat, AMD's struggle for significant enhancements is evident in gaming performance metrics. The RX 7600's performance, let's just say expectations were set higher. Within the demanding realms of CSGO, it nudges ahead of the 3060 and even manages a commendable lead over the 6650 XT. However, in challenges against the 4060, especially in heavyweight titles like Cyberpunk, it's left in the shadows. Now, when it comes to graphically intensive titles, distinctions between the 6650 XT and 7600 start to blur. In areas like Forza, GTA, and Hitman 3, the difference is so subtle, it's almost a game of spot the difference. In our gaming roster attempt, the RX 7600's occasional victories over the 4060 are rarely by noteworthy margins, except, interestingly, in Red Dead Redemption, where AMD seems to have a home field advantage. A curveball though, in the sprawling cityscapes of Spider-Man, the 7600 gets overshadowed by the RK 750. Yes, the RK 750. That's not a misprint. In a nutshell, while the RX 7600 may be positioned as a successor, its performance parallels are unmistakably close to the 6650 XT. Switching gears to our 10 game raster summary at 1080p, some intriguing stats arise. The 4060 is slightly ahead of the 7600, boasting a 3% advantage. At first glance, it might appear marginal, especially recalling those 10 game dynamics. When pitted against its predecessor, the 7600 showcases a commendable lead, outclassing the 6650 XT by a solid 13%. It's an eyebrow raiser given the speculative twine act. Furthermore, it manages an 8% lead over the 3060. Entering the realm of power economics, the 4060 plays it cool, guzzling 18% less power than our 7600. As we delve deeper, the power sipping habits of the 7600 echo those of the 6650 XT, a recurring motif we'll dance to in this video. Yet hats off to the 7600 for managing to be 23% thriftier than the 3060. In the value department, chalk up a win for the 3060. Thanks to some judicious price slashes, it reigns supreme in performance per buck. The 7600 is trailing but stands tall on its own metrics, echoing its spiritual successor vibes. The 7600 delivers 7% more bang for your buck than the 6650 XT, and even manages to make the 4060 look overpriced, outvaluing it by a cool 12%. Now onto the efficiency marathon. Here, the 4060 sprints ahead, outdoing the 7600 by a hefty 25% in performance per watt. Drawing parallels with the 6650 XT, the 7600 sneaks a lead by a slender 7%, and in a triumphant twist, it flaunts a whopping 40% efficiency advantage over the 3060. Venturing into the 1440p realm unveils some captivating trends. The RX 7600's victories over the 4060 become scarcer, with the latter asserting dominance more consistently. Now, turning the lens towards the 7600's direct rival, the narrative flips. In a twist, the 6650XT marginally races ahead of the 7600, sometimes just by a few frames. It underscores just how neck and neck these contenders truly are, a theme consistently echoed in titles like Forza Horizon 5 and GTA 5. As we push to 1440p, the emphasis shifts to GPU prowess, eliminating genuine disparities. Here, our CPU, albeit a hefty 7800 XT, takes a backseat. It's fascinating to witness the 7600's Tengu with its predecessor, especially in games like Hitman 3, where it claims a slight edge. Rainbow Six and Red Dead Redemption bring renewed vigor to the 7600, as they carve out commendable leads. But when put against the 3060, the face-off tightens. Notably, the 3060's gains, akin to those against the 6650XT, become even more pronounced at 1440p than they were at 1080p. Breaking down the 1440p FPS averages, the 4060 bests the 7600 with an imposing 9% lead. The 7600's struggle against the 4060 paints a somber picture. Remember, many view the 4060 as a tepid leap over its predecessor. Now it's disheartening to see the 7600 trailing a card that's already deemed underwhelming. Zooming out, the 7600's marginal victories continue. Against the 3060, it manages a slim 6% advantage, and it's nearly neck and neck with the 6650XT, leading it by a mere 7%. Switching gears to the power consumption, the 4060 remains the poster child for efficiency, sipping 16% less juice than the 7600. Here's some deja vu for you. The 7600 mirrors its ancestor, the 6650XT, in terms of energy use. It's clear, the 7600 is essentially the 6650XT in a new rack. But hey, this is a silver lining. The 7600 outshines the 3060 using 23% less power, so it does have that efficiency feather in its cap. Let's talk bang for your buck. The 3060 is the reigning champ. It's closely tailored by the 7600 in performance per dollar. However, when you stack the 7600 against the 6650XT, they're virtually identical in value. The 4060 is still searching for its sweet spot. Lastly, in the efficiency marathon of performance per watt, the 4060 clinches gold. Our contender, the 7600, is 23% behind, but deserves applause for its relative prowess. It narrowly surpasses the 6650XT by 5% and impressively leaves the 3060 in the dust, leading by a whopping 37%. Diving into rasterization, the AMD 7600 strutted with both fair and falter. At 1080p, it played catch up with the 4060 and mirrored its ancestor, the 6650XT, in a surprising dance. Shifting to 1440p, this dance intensified. Power efficiency? It echoes the 6650XT, but gets a nod for outpacing the 3060. Speaking of value, the 3060 wears the crown, but the 7600 isn't bowing out, closely matching its predecessor. Meanwhile, the 4060 is efficient as ever, and carving its niche. All in all, it's a lively GPU-G. Buckle up and let's slide into the world of ray tracing. The 7600? It started with a stumble in Cyberpunk, trailing behind the 6650XT, but never counted out. It found its stride in F1, overtaking both the 6650XT and 3060. Hitman 3? Well, it seems like a Nvidia-dominated affair, with our 6650XT and 7600 feeling a bit out of place. Zooming out, the RTX 3060 and 4060 are setting the pace, reaffirming Nvidia's stronghold in ray tracing. The 7600 is trying to keep up. Alright, let's break down the numbers on ray tracing performance. The RX 7600? Not its finest hour. The RTX 4060 takes a commanding lead, outclassing the 7600 by a massive 45%. Even the 3060 lands a solid punch, outpacing it by 28%. Compared to the 6650XT, the 7600 pulls ahead, but only by a hair at 5%. Not the lead we were hoping for. In the energy ring, the 4060 stays efficient, sipping 9% less power than the 7600. And while the power draw between the 6650XT and 7600 stays neck and neck, the 7600 does have a feather in its cap, using 28% less power than the 3060. Now for value, the 3060 reigns supreme in performance per dollar. Meanwhile, the 7600 and 6650XT, they're kindred spirits, standing side by side at the chart's lower end. And efficiency? The 4060 wears the crown, offering a staggering 59% more efficiency over the 7600. The 7600 does have a redeeming moment, however, nudging past the 3060 by 10% in this arena. Quite the roller coaster of stats, right? Diving into the 1440p ray tracing waters, the RX 7600 swim is quite well, a tad underwhelming. It goes toe-to-toe with the 6650 XT, and sure, it occasionally outpaces the 3060, but more often, it's trailing behind. In Hitman 3, those 8GB cards, they hit a wall, yet the A750 pushes through, likely thanks to some clever optimization. The 3060 flaunting its ample VRAM laps most of the race, and the 4060 still outpaces the 7600, despite its own hurdles. As we look across other titles, the story feels very familiar. Especially when jumping from 1080p to 1440p, the RX 7600 falls further behind the 3060 and 4060. Wrapping up with the ray tracing gaming summary, our RX 7600's report card has some, let's say, room for improvement. In average FPS, it trails the 4060 by 30% and the 3060 by 23%. It does outdo its older sibling by 12%, but when you look at it, it's a mere baby step forward. Power-wise, the story feels consistent. The 4060 is still the more energy-conscious cousin, consuming 12% less power than the RX 7600. And while the 7600 matches its predecessor in consumption, it does outperform the 3060, being 28% thriftier. Now, if we're talking bang for your buck, the 3060 still wears the crown, offering a whopping 50% more performance per dollar compared to the 7600. It's neck and neck with the 6650 XT and boasts a 15% better deal than the 4060. But when it comes to efficiency, all hail the 4060. With a staggering 64% lead over the 7600, it's the clear champion. Yet in a twist, the 7600, despite its performance quotes, manages to outgreen the 3060 in efficiency by 5%. Go figure. Diving deep into ray tracing, the RX 7600 has had its ups and downs, showing inconsistent performance across all resolutions. While sometimes keeping pace with the 6650 XT and occasionally edging past the 3060, it often found itself overshadowed by the 3060 and 4060. In games like Cyberpunk and Hitman 3, it had distinct challenges, especially as the resolution climbed to 1440p. Power-wise, the 3060 stood out as the most energy efficient, with the 7600 showing savings over the 3060. For overall value, the 3060 dominated, offering the best bang for the buck. Interestingly, in terms of efficiency, the 4060 stole the show, yet the 7600 managed a slight edge over the 3060. Quite the intricate tapestry of performance, wouldn't you say? Alright, let's dive into the world of synthetic benchmarks. Starting with 3DMark, our 7600 does a little victory dance, leading the pack in Firestrike and TimeSpy. However, it stumbles in Port Royal, trailing the 4060, but on the bright side, nudges past the 3060. Remember, this isn't a perfect reflection of gaming tests. It's more like a star-studded highlight reel. Shifting to Blender, our 7600 struggles, losing to the 4060 by a hefty 65% and the 3060 by 61%. It's clear that the card's core count is a bit of an Achilles heel, but in a family showdown, it does edge past the 6650 XT by 8%. Luxmark paints an intriguing picture. While the A750 sits proudly at the top, the 7600 is trailing, losing to the 4060 by 22% and the 3060 by 10%. Still though, it manages a 10% lead over the 6650 XT. Onto Passmark performance tests, which gives a tour of various APIs. Here, the 7600 slips, falling behind the 6650 XT by 4%, with the 4060 and 3060 outpacing it by 31% and 18% respectively. In Adobe Suite Puget Bench, the results vary. In After Effects, the 7600 narrowly outpaces the 4060, but trails the 3060 by 20%, managing a respectable 6% lead over the 6650 XT. Premiere Pro though puts a spotlight on AMD's encoding performance. The 7600 lags behind the 4060 by 6% and the 3060 by 17%. Surprisingly, it one-ups its predecessor by 9%. Last but not least is SpecVBurf, which has AMD flexing a bit. In tests like Maya, the 7600 shines, besting the 4060 by 8% and the 3060 by 25%. While it loses some ground in SolidWorks to the 4060, it rebounds by outperforming the 3060 by 16%. And in 3ds Max, it's the 7600's moment, surpassing both Nvidia cards by considerable margin. Yet the 6650 XT still manages to pull a win in Maya, hinting at some AMD optimization quirks. Alright, let's dip our toes into the world of overclocking. with the RX 7600. If I had to describe it in one word, it would be restraint. You're kind of locked in by those sliders. You can't push beyond 112% power limit and a 3000 MHz core clock or a 2400 MHz memory clock. And what kind of magic does that unlock? You're probably itching to know. Hold on to your hats. It's a not so dazzling 2% boost in average frame rate. The lows remain quite steady, but there is a little silver lining. The 0.1% lows see a pretty significant uptick by 41%, though I suspect that's more thanks to the power limit being pushed to 112% than the overclock itself. And let's talk about the trade-offs. Expect your 7600 to be a tad bit noisier, warming up by 3% and humming 8% louder. And the power? It jumps up to a solid 12% increase. All this just to squeeze out a wee bit more performance. Some might say it's a bit much for not so much in return. Alright folks, that's the AMD Radeon RX 7600. Think of it as a comforting childhood teddy bear of the GPUs. Familiar and enduring, but not the next gaming prodigy. AMD, perhaps having hit the snooze button once too often, has given us what feels like more like a twin to the RX 6650 XT than its groundbreaking hit. In 1080p performance, the RX 7600 has its flashes of brilliance, sometimes outpacing its competitor, yet often it finds itself chasing the shadows. At 1440p, it faces stiff competition, notably from the RTX 3060 and 4060. Ray tracing? The RX 7600 gave it a good shot, but Nvidia's lineup usually has the upper hand. And while you can overclock, be prepared for more noise, heat, and thirstier power draw. But it's not all grace, guys. The RX 7600 displays sparks of potential in benchmarks, and even outshone its predecessor, the RX 6650 XT, in a few matchups. To sum it up, the RX 7600 is reliable and budget-friendly, but it stops short of being revolutionary. It's a solid choice for consistent performance, but if you're dreaming of the next big thing in GPUs, you might want to hold off and see what's on the horizon. Anyways guys, that's all for today. Make sure to do all the usual stuff, like go watch the video on the screen right now, get subscribed, and turn on notifications. We'll have the 4060 review up on the screen right now.